Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.3, Problem 3. This is Section 9.3, Problem number 3. It says, Rachel Researcher asked 900 shoppers in the parking lot of the Market Basket in New Bedford if they use coupons when they shop. 360 said they did use coupons. Find a 95% confidence interval for the proportion of Market Basket shoppers that use coupons. So a confidence interval for a population proportion is p hat plus or minus the square root of p hat times 1 minus p hat over n all times z sub c, the confidence coefficient. So that's the formula we're going to have to fill in and calculate. So first of all, p hat is the population proportion that we're estimating. So p hat will be r, the number of successful results, over n, the total number of trials. So in this case, that r, number of successful results, is 360. Over the total number of trials is 900. So that's something it does reduce. You're probably not going to be able to do it too comfortably without your calculator. So just do 360 divided by 900 equals, and it comes out to a pretty reasonable 0.4. So that's our p hat that we're going to plug into the formula. So in the far left, p hat plus or minus will be 0.4 plus or minus. And now the square root of p hat, 0.4, times 1 minus p hat is 1 minus 0.4, over n, that's the size of our sample, so in this case 900, the 900 choppers that were asked, if they use coupons. And then z sub c is the confidence coefficient. So we have a little chart where for 95%, that's a commonly asked confidence level, the z sub c is 1.96. So that's how it fills in. Now we start doing the computation. So what I'd like to do first is work down the stuff in the square root. So we'll have 0.4 plus or minus the square root of 0.4 times 1 minus 0.4 is 0.6 over 900. Let me make that square root a little bigger because the whole thing is under the square root. The 900 is under the square root. Times 1.96. So let me do one more step. Well, let's bring it over here. It'll be 0.4 plus or minus the square root of, so in the numerator, 0.4 times 0.6, that I can do without a calculator, is 0.24 over 900 times 1.96. So now I've probably gone about as far as I'm going to go without my calculator. So I have 0.4 plus or minus the square root of an answer I'm going to get in a second, times 1.96. So 0.24 divided by 900. Let's see what I get for that. So the number under the square root is 0.00026666666. The sixes will go on forever. So I just put a line over it. So that's the number under the square root. And while it's on the screen of my calculator, I'll just press my square root button. So the square root of that decimal, square root, is 0.01632 9931. So I have 0.4 plus or minus 0.01632 9931 times 1.96. So now what I can do is multiply this 0.016 number that's on the screen of the calculator times the 1.96, my confidence coefficient. So I'll have 0.4 plus or minus, and when I multiply that, I get 0.03200665. We can round that off a little bit. So I'll do 0.4 plus or minus, let's call it 0.032. The 0, 0 after, with any type of sensible round off, we'll call it 0.032. So now my confidence interval will be, it'll go from a low end of 0.4 minus 0.032 to 0.4 plus 0.032. So the low end of my confidence interval is 0.3682, and when I add 0.4 plus 0.032, it'll be 0.432. So I'm 95% sure that this is an interval that the true population proportion is in, somewhere between about 37% with some round off and 43%. That's the proportion of shoppers at that store, Market Basket, New Bedford, that I expect would use coupons when they shop.